Hi, JohnX here. Welcome to my new lesson series where I'll teach you how to become the ultimate drummer without ever picking up a pair of sticks. Be sure to purchase my ebook to follow along with this lesson series. In the following lessons, you won't be learning new sticking patterns, grooves, licks, or fills. You will, however, learn how to become a better drummer and a better musician by gaining a much deeper understanding of the music you're playing. You'll learn about song, form, and structure as it pertains to rock, pop, and blues music. You'll learn how to identify the different sections of a song and the function each one of them serves in a piece of music. You'll learn how to hear, count, and feel four-bar phrases, which are an essential aspect of many different musical styles. And you'll learn how to read, write, and create drum charts so you can quickly and easily learn new music. To begin, I would like to tell you why it became absolutely necessary for me to learn how to better understand song form and to learn how to read and write drum charts. In 1964, the Beatles appeared on the Ed Sullivan TV show. When I saw Ringo playing his four-piece Ludwig drum kit, I was hooked. Shortly thereafter, I picked up a pair of sticks and beat on books, pails, and anything that looked or sounded like a drum. Eventually, I got my first kit and played along with records for hours at a time. I was in my first band playing professionally by the time I was 17 years old, and I sounded pretty good. To learn a new song, I would play along with the recording until I could play it from memory, and this method worked okay for me. However, I often had a sense that I didn't fully understand what I was doing and often felt that I was playing in the gray zone. I didn't know how many bars there were in each section of the song, and anything beyond the verse, chorus, and solos, I wasn't sure what the names of the other sections were even called. Then, at 21 years old, my band broke up. I loved drumming more than anything and really wanted to make a career in music. However, I knew down deep that in order to compete at a professional level, I needed to be much more knowledgeable. I had never taken a lesson, I couldn't read a note of music, and didn't know the difference between a paradiddle and a flam. Remember, this was way before DVDs and YouTube. So off to college I went. I learned how to read music, and I learned how to play some rudiments. I studied music history, music theory, piano, and composition. I also got to perform in a wide variety of different musical groups, ranging from jazz combos and big bands to orchestras and percussion ensembles. But guess what? I still felt I was playing in the gray zone when performing rock, pop, and blues music outside of the college environment. The game-changing moment came for me when I had to learn 20 songs in 1 week. There simply wasn't enough time to play the songs over and over until I could memorize them. I was forced to find a better method for learning new music, and now I would like to share this method with you. To start, we'll take a look at the different sections or the different parts of a song. I'll identify each one and describe the function it serves in a piece of music. A verse is the part of the song that tells a story. What is the song about? Love, war, peace, politics, you name it. Think of any subject and you know a song has been written about it. The chorus is the most recognizable part of the song. It repeats throughout and often has the song title in it. The chorus is also sometimes referred to as the hook. It's called that because it's the part of the song that hooks you in. It's also the part that most people hear in their head when they think of the song. Here's a perfect example of a song chorus that everyone will easily recognize. The pre-chorus is the part of the song that precedes or sets up the chorus. It's also typically played the same throughout the song. A bridge is used to break up the monotony of a song that might go from a verse to a chorus, a verse to a chorus, a verse to a chorus. You throw a bridge in there and it keeps the song a lot more interesting. A bridge is typically played once in a song and is typically in a different key signature. Intros are used to introduce or start a song. An intro could be based on a verse or a chorus, but would be played without vocals. An intro could also be based on a riff. A classic example is the guitar riff at the beginning of Smoke on the Water by Deep Purple. An outro is used to end a song. Quite often, an outro will be based on the chorus. Sometimes you'll hear the band play the chorus over and over, and a soloist will be playing in the background. That creates a lot of energy and it's used a lot. Typically, when that happens, there will be a fade out at the end of a song. Sometimes you'll hear the vocalist vamp or improvise over the chorus, and it will repeat and then eventually fade out. An outro could also be based on the intro or a riff. Once you get comfortable recognizing all of the different song sections, you'll be able to easily recognize what the outro is based on. Hear how the outro for the song I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett is based on the chorus. An interlude is a part of the song that composers will often use after a verse and chorus to leave a little space between the next verse and chorus. An interlude can be based on another section of the song or a riff, and it's typically played without vocals. Listen to the interlude for Like a Stone by Audioslave. Notice that it comes after the first chorus and before the second verse. A vamp is a section of the song that's based on a repeated groove or riff. Sometimes the band will vamp and the vocalist or soloist will improvise over it. Other times, the composer will use an instrumental vamp between sections of a song, much like an interlude. Solo sections are used to feature the instrumentalists in the band and are quite often based on a part or parts of a song, such as a verse and or a chorus. In rock music, the guitar player takes most of the solos. However, any instrumentalist can take a solo. The breakdown is the section of the song where some of the instrumentalists drop out or stop playing. For example, you might have a verse where the bass and drums drop out and the guitar and vocals play by themselves, or the entire band drops out and the drums and vocals play by themselves. On the first verse on Like a Stone, notice the whole band is playing. On a cobweb, afternoon in a room full of emptiness. Now, listen to the third verse, and you'll notice it breaks down to just guitar and vocals. On a rim, until the day was gone, and I said, well, that wraps up this lesson. I sure hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for the next lesson in this series, where I'll teach you how to quickly learn songs without having to play them over and over until they're memorized. I'll see you again soon. Bye now. It's your thing.